the way it's developed is that first we had text databases. So now we have text databases. We're now starting to develop, in this project that I've talked about with the GIS project, we're starting to develop digital mapping capabilities. What would be the next big step that we could take at a infrastructural level? In other words, if we think about digital history as resting on a series of developments, digital developments, that make the doing of history more accessible, easier, allow us to incorporate much more data information than before. Clearly, text databases, the fact that all of a sudden an enormous number of texts have become concordances, right? Rather than just a few concordances for major texts. Searchable texts, that's one thing. Maps is another big development. What's the next big development that we really need? And I think that the next big development are relational databases, that we have to start devoting resources to culling, creating databases that have information, data in them, call them historical record that other people can share. And that's a big project. It's also very tedious. Right? It involves intellectual decisions at lots of points and interesting problems, but and design problems. But I think it's probably the big next step that's going to change the way we do history. Because what it means is that you will be able to go back to the 18th century. Oh, you can already start to do this now, right? And look at 18th century or late 18th century, early 19th century census data in the United States. And you can start to look at it, and you can start to see it on a map. And you can start to read texts that relate to this information. And so your working environment can be more digital now. And so you can look at a broader area with more information than ever before, which allows you to start to isolate and pinpoint places and times and issues that where you, by working individually, by going to archives, by drilling down more deeply, can actually make a real contribution. But I think databases, relational databases, is going to be the next giant step forward, but also the most difficult. Before digital texts had become ubiquitous, but they were beginning to become more common, among my colleagues in the humanities, there was tremendous suspicion about diverting the library budget from print to digital. And people were tended to create an opposition between print and digital. I don't think there's anybody today who would not use a digital searchable text if they could get their hands on it. And now, in fact, people insist, right, that the library make sure they have the digital texts that they want in their field. And why don't you have it? And now, please, immediately. So I think that this has been a major. Does it, well, what's happening, I look at mapping and spatial analysis. I think there's, I find among my colleagues in Chinese history, a good number say, what's the point of this? We don't need this. Why this investment? Is it really useful? Who's done anything useful with it? And, you know, I think that's going to change because are maps still part of what we how we think about the world? You betcha. The question is whether, in this case, with maps or the GIS, it's enabling new kinds of research that historians haven't done before. And that involves, that's not such a quick change. I mean, they did know how to read before, right? And so when you had digital text, they could do new things with it. But they didn't have, they haven't done spatial analysis before. And so that is new, and that will take more time.